Hello, Shehalas. How's everyone doing? I hope you guys are all enjoying this beautiful sunshine that we've been having lately. As I look at the weather forecast, I don't think it's going anywhere anytime soon, so continue to enjoy that sunshine. Also, I hope you have subscribed to our YouTube page. That's where most of our content is showing. That's where our sermons and our devotionals have been posted. If you haven't already, please subscribe. Find out if any other church members need help with that and give them a hand by allowing them to subscribe. Also, our Facebook page, please like us on Facebook and follow us on Facebook if you don't already do. A lot of our content there is being posted along with the Washington Conference, Sabbath school lessons and sermons along the way. I wanted to give you a quick update on what's going on. As you know, we're posting everything on YouTube and Facebook, so it's important that we can continue to look at the church's Facebook and YouTube page for any new content. Along this week, Brian Carlton and Zane have given me a call. They're wanting to create a list of people that are willing to help those that can't make it to the grocery store. So if you're someone that would like to help and provide some aid to go in shopping to the grocery store, please give myself a call or Zane or Brian Carlton and Pastor John. What the plan is to create a map around those that want to help and be able to do some of those food deliveries to those that need it within the area and the map and the geographical area. I know Karen Carlton is also making masks. She has a team they're sewing some face masks together. So if you're someone that would like a face mask, please give me a call or text or email Karen Carlton. For today's devotional, Pastor Hans from Seattle has been kind enough to volunteer, so he will be having this Wednesday's devotional. Again, hope you guys all have a wonderful week, and see you on Sabbath.
Hello, everyone. I hope all is well. I don't have a lot of time, so I'm going to get right to it. My name is Hans, and I'm doing this for Pastor Etter for your devotion. So I've been studying Psalms 23, and Psalms 23 is an amazing verse. I know it's very simple. We know it by heart. But for a time like this, it is very key to understand and break down Psalms 23. So one of the things that I find very, very grand about Psalms 23, when it says, "Yea, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. For thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me." And at a time like this, is this chaotic moment in this life that we're dealing with now, it seems like, wow, we are actually walking in the valley of the shadow of death. And while we're walking in the valley of the shadow of death, David didn't say that God's going to take us and bring us around the valley of the shadow of death. No. Or will God take us and fly us over the valley of the shadow of death? No. Rather, David said, we're going to walk through difficult times. We're going to walk through this valley. We're going to walk through this shadow of death. However, don't fear, because I am with you. It says the rod, my rod and my staff, they are there to comfort you. And if the rod is in one part of your hand and the staff is another, you're covered by both sides. One of the things that I like, if you go to the first verse, it will say, "He leads me in the path of righteousness for His name's sake." When someone is leading you, that means the person is in front of you. So God is not only covering us on both sides; rather, He is also leading us. So that means whatever is going to come in our forefront, it's going to have to go into God before it touches us. So if something's coming in front of us, God is already there. So He's there to take that impact before it touches us. So that's another great part of that verse. I wonder if I could go throughout all of it. So we have covered in our left and our right. We have covered in our front. And it says, it continues by saying, "You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows." If a person is anointing your head, the person has to be above you, right? So if a person is above you, which means that God is now covering us. So it's not, he's not only on our sides with our rod and our staff or in leading us to the path of righteousness, he's also covering our heads with oil, meaning that he's above us. So that means he has, we have coverage from on top, we have coverage from the side, and we also have coverage in the front. But you would ask me, hey, Pastor Hines, what about the back? The verse is not done. It continues by saying, surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. So if goodness and mercy is following us, that means if someone is following us, that means someone is behind us, right? So if someone is behind us, that means our back is covered. So that means God also has himself covering us from the back. So not only from the sides, on our left, on our right, in the front, or above us, but he is also covering us from behind. And that is amazing. So we have full coverage in the front, both on our left and our right, above us and behind us. If we want to be technical, like, hey, how about under us? The verse still continues. It says, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And when we're dwelling in the house of the Lord, that means we're standing on solid ground. That means we are standing on the solid rock, which is Christ, in Christ alone. So he's covering us from in front, on our sides, above, from behind, and we are standing on solid ground. So I just wanted to leave you that with that. There's no need to be afraid of what's happening around this world, as what's happening now with the COVID-19 virus, but just have peace, because God gives us peace that passes all understanding. And this peace that he gives us, the world doesn't have. So while the world is being chaotic, God is there saying, hey, relax, chill, I got this. I got you. I'm covering you. You're going to walk through this valley, but while you're walking through this valley, I'm with you. So I hope you have a great rest of the week, and stay safe. Keep washing your hands, being healthy, and do what the government says. Social distancing. It's okay. Well, that's all I have to say. And I hope God blesses you all and you have a wonderful week.
Sometimes it's hard to breathe, all these thoughts that shout at me, trying to bring me to my knees, and it's overwhelming. Darkness echoes all around, feels like everything's crashing down, till I know where my hope is found, and it's only you. You say you're working everything for my good, and ooh, I believe every word. 'Cause even in the madness, there is peace, drowning out the voices all around me. Through all this chaos, you are writing a symphony, and even in the madness, there is peace, drowning out the voices all around me. Through all this chaos, you are writing a symphony, a symphony. My heart to your beat, let me be your melody. Even when I cannot see what you're orchestrating, even when the dark surrounds, you'll never let me drown. I know that my hope is found in the name of Jesus. Ooh, you say you're working everything for my good, and ooh, I believe every word. The voices all around me, through all this chaos, you are writing a symphony, and even in the madness, there is peace, drowning out the voices all around me, through all this chaos, you are writing a symphony, oh. Symphony. the voices all around me through all this chaos. You were writing a symphony, and even in the madness, there is peace. Drowning out the voices all around me through all this chaos.